Hello everybody. A series about animation would not be complete without talking about morphs. There are quite a few tutorials out, but as far at least as I saw them, they all use the same method, namely having morph starting and morph target all in the same mesh. Or so they work like this. You have a cube, for example, doesn't matter. Let's go to the lists tab, then add a new map. I call it M1 for morph map 1. Then I click and create a new one, M2. Now I can move this cube up and rotate it and resize it, whatever I like to do. Now I have my two maps, and this is my starting map and this is my target map, and I can morph between these two geometries. I can also add a third or a fourth or a fifth one, doesn't really matter. And if I add geometry in one of the maps, like hitting the D key, this geometry will automatically also be added to the other maps. Okay, now sometimes it's not possible to just deform some geometry in the same mesh. I try to think of a practical example, and I thought deforming a spring would be one of these cases. And also if you bring in geometry from another application. So let me switch to this one here, and you see here I have three items. I have the cylinder, I have a target mesh, and I have a start mesh. And the reason why I think it's not possible to just deform this is when we deform this spring, I resize it, for example, it still is a spiral, but it is flat. It's not a spring anymore. And in this case, we need two different geometries. I undo this. And what's important is both the start and the target need to have the same amount of vertices or the same amount of geometry. You see here I have 1178 polygons. The start has the same 1178 polygons for the spring. So let's create these morph maps. So I select a new map, call this one start, then create a new map again, call it target, and we have the possibility to use different meshes which are then combined or attached to one mesh for the morph. So make sure the target is selected here. Make sure you don't have enable deformers activated here, otherwise we won't see if it has worked. And now I can go to vertex map and click on background morph. And here we have the option of using background or last selection. I use the background, and now you see it has created our target. And we have now two morph maps, one with the start configuration and one from this other mesh with the target configuration. So we don't need to see the target anymore. We can look at it like this here. And if you would like to animate it, we now need a morph influence, which we can either select here, or we could also have selected it here from Add Deformers Influences Morph Influence, which is exactly the same. And it has been assigned to the start mesh, and we have a morph influence here. And if you go to the properties, you see the morph map, which, let's see this, which is selected is the start, and if we would change the strength here, then nothing would happen. We must select the target, and if you want to animate it in the model tab here, then you need to enable deformers, but I warn you, this can give you other problems. But just to demonstrate, now we can see how this morph looks like. We can also see how it looks if we select the strength here, press the C key to bring up a channel wall, and now we can use this here to play around with it. But now, if you have done this and you go back to the properties, you all of a sudden see that no morph map is selected. If you try to expand this, it says the command is disabled. And I think it's a bug. You can just select some other item, then go back to the morph influence. And now it is possible again to switch the targets. Okay, let me disable this. I think it's good practice to go to the Setup tab and use or finish the morph from here. So first I make this locator a bit smaller and make the cylinder visible, and now we can morph this, and you see it goes above 100, it goes below 0. And if we want to limit this to 0 and 100, we need a user channel. So I put in a new locator, W key, bring this one down below here, and make it smaller also by putting in a 0 size. So with this locator selected, we can go to the channels display and click here on Add User Channel, or on the Modifiers tab, Add a User Channel. Here it asks us what this channel should be called. I say Spring Morph and it is a percentage, default value is 0, use minimum value, use maximum, and maximum is 100. Now we have this channel, and I can bring it into the schematic view here, then go to the morph influence channel, and use the strength here and bring this also into the schematic view. And now we have coupled it, and if I press the C key now, I have my spring morph. It goes up to 100, not further, it goes to 0, and we could animate this now. Just for completeness, I would like to show something else as well. So in item mode, I select my cylinder, go to edit, center to bounding box bottom, like so, then select everything except the light and the camera and parent it to the cylinder. Now, if I rotate this, we still can use our rotation and it will, sorry, wrong one. And it will work properly regardless of the location of my spring. So I rotate it back, and to show how to make a complete controller, first what we can do is whenever I click this locator here, I can make that the channel hole is activated by going to the assembly tab and activate one of the preset commands, in this case item channel hole. And now if I click on this locator, it brings up this spring morph automatically. And to see how we could add other stuff also, I go to this cylinder properties, and I want to have all the rotation channels also brought into here. So select this, then go to my locator, add a user channel, call it X, and this is an angle, default is 0, minimum is minus 90, and this one is plus 90. Then I can add another user channel, call it Y, and another one, call it Z. And now I can wire in my X, Y, and Z. This is not a good example, it just shows how this works. And if I click on my locator now, I can bring this up and I have all my channel rotations, and I have my spring which works. What I can also do now is I can select this cylinder, right click on it and say duplicate hierarchy, W key. Here we have some double transforms for whatever reason. W, bring it back. And now if I select this locator, it will B for my right target. If I select this one, it will be for my left one. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching. Take care and have fun modeling with Modo. See you some other time. If you have questions or so, please enter them in the comments. Bye-bye.